Hello, my friends. During the period when I was painting at my friend Mitchell's from the end of 1974 to the beginning of 1975, I had fallen madly in love with Françoise, a Franco-Vietnamese half-breed who lived in the building next to Rosenthal Street. But she was living with someone, and I was living with Paula, and we had to meet wherever we could, from the workshop at Mitchell's to an uninhabited studio crowded with moving boxes in Levallois, where we would go on my Honda 750 motorcycle. I had been in love with Paula, to the point of inviting her to accompany me to Brazil on my first trip at the end of 1973. One day, when I saw her writing a letter, I was surprised to realize that she was writing to another boy to tell him how much she loved him and that she couldn't wait to throw them herself into his arms. Great God! On the way back, after 3 days seeing that she was still there, she told me that she had gone to see her girlfriend with whom she was living with and that she had set up a relationship with the person she was writing to. She advised her to stay at my house since she did not know where to live anymore. I accepted because she had pleasant qualities, but it was no longer true love. So when I met Françoise, I was emotionally available, but neither she nor I had a place to live together. With Paula and Jacqueline, her sister, we moved to Rue de Lancrie in the 10th arrondissement of Paris, in the beautiful apartment I have been living in since then. After a while, they both left and I found myself free. I was so much in love that I asked Françoise to marry me. As we were at the end of November, I proposed her to wait to the day of the New Year's Day to give me her answer. But in less than a month, she showed a fierce jealousy that was totally unjustified. There was no longer any question of marriage, although I tried to give her proof of love by spending 6 months restoring a small studio on Main Avenue that she had bought. Nothing helped. We broke up for good, and my morale plummeted so badly that the only time in my life I tried to commit suicide. I was in the subway at the beginning of the platform of the École Militaire station. As the train arrived, as I was about to throw myself under the seat, I felt an invisible hand pressing on my chest, pushing me backward to the wall. Then the tension subsided, and I got into the wagon. It was the first time I felt something from another world. Now I realized that it was destiny who intervened to prevent the marriage, which probably would not have allowed me to perform the extasium, and also to prevent me from this final act. It intervened even later in a different form. I had received at home a beautiful West Indian woman, France, who had come to draw the cards and tell me my future. I was very doubtful, but I agreed to take part in the experiment to see if there was anything credible in this predictive discipline. She made me draw a few cards, but when it was time to interpret them, she looked at her watch and told me that she had to leave. She left me with her book, where she was learning these techniques, and told me to do the interpretation myself, which was even better to assess the reality of the predictions. There was one prediction per month over 6 months. They all turned out to be correct, including the death of my little Siamese cat, Mousseline. But most importantly, for the last and most important mention, was made of two blonde women, mother and daughter, who were described as bad. Sometime later, however, I received a phone call from a woman working for a high-class Arab magazine, asking me if I would be willing to advertise there. I immediately understood why. She had seen a page of advertising for my painting in a beautiful book. I had met a boy, a lover and collector of Rolls Royce, who was about to publish a very luxurious book on the history of these cars. He offered me the exchange of one of my electronic paintings for publication. Obviously, I was very interested in promoting my work with such a support that could be seen by great decorators and other potential customers. In fact, there was no result, except the call of this lady, to whom I explained that my means did not allow me this kind of expense. She suggested to write a report on me, and we made an appointment. When she arrived, immediately I thought of the prediction. She was blonde, whereas my tastes are mainly for brunettes, and accompanied by her blonde daughter as well, both beautiful and sophisticated. I forgot the bad side, because we both fell in love at first sight with each other. No more reportage, but the beginning of a love relationship. In addition, her name was Françoise, wore John of Harclair like the brunette Françoise, and was also of Earth the sign of Sagittarius. Then began an ambiguous relationship, because I felt she was very stuck, and our relationship was not moving forward. She was the wrong prediction. She invited me to visit her in her suburban lodge, and I discovered that among all her books spread out on the table, there was one that I had already heard about, Allan Kardec's Books of Spirits. I opened it at random and very doubtful. That was the last time I used that word. It was about questions and answers supposedly given by spirits. The first one I came across: do we have a guardian angel? The answer: we all have incarnated or disincarnated guardian spirit, but one in particular, back home, demoralized, because my love relationship was not progressing, nor the sale of my paintings. I sat in the dark, in the fetal position. At that moment, I remember what I've read, and I said to myself, without believing it, that if my protecting spirit existed, it was time to manifest. To my great surprise, I immediately felt a very pleasant energy rising from my feet into my legs. I wondered what was going to happen when I got to the head. But at this point, I figured I had nothing to lose. Then I perceived, for the first time without my eyes, two shiny gray lines about 4 centimeters in diameter running from my temples to the ceiling, where I saw part of a vaguely spherical shape of the same shiny gray. There were a lot of circles, a bit like chestnut bugs, but rounded and very soft in appearance. It didn't last long, and I came down peacefully. Never again did I have a deep depression like before, even though I still had depressed moments later in the face of such a difficult search that was never ending and without support.